Let me spend the next 10-15 minutes presenting key highlights of the eCurve Impact Report. The link to download the report will be available in the chat window, so please keep a look on that. Viraj highlighted the challenge that India faces due to rapid urbanization in the next decade. This will lead to exponential rise in demand for citizen services, and we believe that technology will play a very critical role in enabling such a large-scale transformation. But we also know that technology is only one piece of the puzzle. And we have been at this effort for the last 17 years, and it's really satisfying to see the footprint of eGov span across 2,400 cities in 14 states, impacting over 160 million citizens. Next slide, please. Next slide. We have enabled our cities to become financially, We have enabled our cities to become financially stronger by collecting more than 15,000 crore in revenues. We have also enabled citizen participation in governance by helping register and redress over 3.5 million grievances on the platform. And the platform also enabled over 25 million transactions between citizens and the local government. Next slide. When we think about impact, we look at our most important stakeholder, which is the citizens. Next slide. And the ecosystem of stakeholders that revolves around improving the lives of Indian citizens includes city and state government, central government, administrators and frontline employees, businesses, academia, research institutions, and civil society. And through our mission, we strive to meet the objectives of all our stakeholders. Apart from focusing on ease of living and participation for citizens, our impact framework also measures gains in efficiency for the employees, financial stability of the ULBs, use of data and decision-making, and new solutions built on the digit platform. And finally, the framework is meaningful only if it is positively contributing to improving trust amongst participants, building state capacity, and providing equitable access to everyone. Our first, our very first impact report is our humble effort to highlight the challenge that eGov and our partner ecosystem have managed to bring in the lives of citizens working alongside the government. And we have tried to package this experience as a playbook and open sourced it to drive transformation and scale and speed across the country. Now, what we've done is we have attempted to present our entire experience working with the states like Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Odisha in the report as case studies with objective evaluation of what has worked and what is still work in progress. Now, let me start with Andhra Pradesh. Our engagement with AP is very special, as this was the first time we had an opportunity to drive statewide urban governance transformation. As we all know, AP has been a pioneer in leveraging technology for citizen-centric governance. In 2015, government of AP decided to create a common digital platform for all 110 ULBs in the state. The effort was combined with creation of new online channels while leveraging existing offline channels for citizens to interact and access their local government. The AP government articulated a very clear vision, not just to resolve urban governance challenge in the state, but actually to raise the bar for municipal governance and service delivery for the entire country. Fast forward today, and the results are really noteworthy. Next slide. The program impacted the lives of more than 1.4 crore citizens by digitizing over 35 citizen services. And as part of the program, government also took a very bold step of publishing citizen charter. Not just that, in a radical departure from the norm, government also publicly announced the policy to compensate the citizens in case of slippage of SLAs. Now, this strong focus on quality of service resulted in 90% of citizen requests being serviced within publicly announced SLAs and reduction of grievance redressal time from 24 days to just 5 days. That's an improvement of over 500%. Next slide. The strong focus on eliminating manual process and digitizing it helped build trust on the system data. Another bold decision by the government was to improve the trust and participation by the citizen was to make a number of dashboards completely public. And today a citizen can visit AP Municipal Administration website and view real-time data on number of services, including grievances, property tax, etc., as well as various other indicators for the city, ward, or locality. Next slide. One of the main benefits of a digitally enabled governance is that state leaders, administrators, and ULB employees can have access to reliable and structured data. This substantially improves the ability to manage ULB performance and direct resources to high traffic areas. Next slide. One of the core tenets of a truly public platform is that it provides the ability for others to solve instead of trying to solve everything itself. The open architecture of the platform has allowed multiple new solutions to be built and integrated with the platform. This has not only resulted in states' ability to innovate faster, but also save time and money in avoiding duplication in building the foundation layers which already existed on the core platform. And some examples of the solutions integrated on the platform are the property registration department integrated stamps and registration system with the property tax system to enable one-step issuance of mutation certificate, which is a big deal. Second, land records department integrated Bhu Aadhaar, which was built by NIC, to provide verification of land ownership through land's use life cycle. One more example is citizen satisfaction captured through IVRS was in the PGR application, the public grievance redressal application on the platform, to analyze the quality of services rendered for continuous improvement. Next slide. And to highlight the versatility of the platform, when the government launched doorstep delivery of citizen services, the platform enabled enrollment of over 30,000 ward secretaries and over 1.5 lakh ward volunteers on the platform. And the impact was to establish a very vibrant and effective service delivery system for the state. Today, over 90% of service requests flows through this network. And this has helped prevent corruption, discrimination, and this infrastructure was also rapidly repurposed to handle emergency situation like COVID. Next slide. Finally, in a recently concluded survey by independent third party to study the impact of Nagar Seva platform on the lives of citizens and employees, the results were very satisfying. More than 74% of citizens saw greater access to government, with over 60% also seeing enhanced service delivery. Employees reported tremendous improvement in productivity, with over 11 hours saved per week from manual process, and over 96% seeing significant improvement in their ability to serve the citizens. Next slide. Now coming to Punjab, our partnership with PMIDC started back in 2018. And after years of struggling to procure a commercial software to digitize citizen services, in March of 2018, under the leadership of PMIDC CEO Shri Ajoy Sharma, PMIDC decided to go with Ego Open Platform, Digit. The team felt that this platform-based approach will be faster to roll out and enable the state to build its capacity at a much lower cost. And rightly so, this was one of the fastest rollout of Digit platform we have seen anywhere. What has typically taken about 2 to 3 years in many other states for a program of similar nature, 100 ULBs in Punjab went live in just 90 days' time. This platform has brought many transformative changes in the employee productivity, improved citizen access to local government, and a whole new level of transparency and accountability in the system. Next slide. One example of this is miscellaneous collection. Before Digit, the ULB employees had been using paper-based manual G8 slips while collecting miscellaneous payments for things like advertisement tax, parking charges, outdoor media charges, etc. And this process using manual G8 slips had several disadvantages. It was prone to error, prone to damage, hard to make changes, and increased chances of malpractices by the employees themselves. To prevent the leakage of revenue and all these disadvantages, in August of 2019, just a year ago, miscellaneous collection system was introduced to digitize the entire process. The revenue from this collection increased multifold from 13 crore per quarter to over 200 crore collected within a year. And this was possible due to a combination of policy intervention, which eliminated the manual process and thereby curbing revenue leakage and very easy to use application for the collections. Apart from miscellaneous collection, all types of revenues and charges have also seen very good increase. Last year, the total revenues collected on the platform was more than 500 crore, which includes property tax, miscellaneous collection, trade license fees, water and sewerage charges. And this has helped in improving financial sustainability of the ULBs. Next slide. To make it really easy to access municipal services, Ego and PMIDC have partnered to launch MSeva WhatsApp chatbot just a few weeks ago. Now, citizens can access services by simply chatting on WhatsApp. No need to download any app or go to ULB offices. Since its launch, we are already seeing between 15 to 20% of complaints now being logged using WhatsApp. And eGov and TMIDC are committed to expand the range of services accessible through mSewa chatbot, and citizens in Punjab should soon be able to access a lot more services, including viewing and paying bills via WhatsApp. Next slide. Finally, this story cannot be completed without stating that the most unique thing about our engagement with Punjab was that right from the beginning, the state was very keen to build their own capacity and to deploy and manage the platform. They assembled a terrific team of 20 people consisting of project managers, solution architect, engineers, and along with eGov, we spent close to 1,100 hours in Bangalore and over 7,000 hours of online training to enable the team on Digit platform. Today, the team is not only self-sufficient in managing day-to-day operations of the platform, but has already started enhancing and building new solutions on the platform. It is very satisfying to see the state taking ownership of the platform and be self-sufficient. This is a marked departure from the approach taken by most other states, and full credit goes to Shri Ajoy Sharma and his team. We are fortunate to have Ajoy participate in the upcoming panel discussion, where I'm sure we will hear more from him. Next slide. Apart from Punjab, few other states where Digit is being rolled out are Uttarakhand. The program is ongoing, it's called as Nagar Seva, and is currently live in 60 of the 90 urban local bodies. Odisha, the program is called as Sujog, and it is a critical part of the 5T initiative of the Odisha government. And the program has just kick-started a few weeks ago. We also have Shri Mati Vatanam, Principal Secretary, UD Government of Odisha, joining us in the upcoming panel discussion. And I'm sure we will hear more from him about this vision for the program. Next slide. Chandigarh Smart City. This was a significant milestone in our partnership journey. Chandigarh Smart City was the first city where a partner rolled out Digit completely on their own. And this program is very ambitious, with 31 modules being planned to go live, of which 11 are already live. This is a great example where a commercial player leveraged a public digital platform like Digit and worked with the government to deliver value to the society. The last one I want to highlight is Ich Hauni. Most recent addition to the customer list is the Ministry of Defense. They have chosen Digit Platform and Bell as the implementation partner to provide online citizen services across all 62 cantonment boards of India. And the entire program was conceived and set up during the COVID period without anyone from eGov or partner organization having to travel. Next slide. Working with partners has been a way of life for all of us at eGov. Significant effort of our product engineering and partnership team goes in helping partners be successful in their state engagements. And in the last 18 months, we have enabled over 15 partners. Our team have conducted over 150 partner enablement sessions and spent close to 11,000 hours on partner training. We now also have over 150 artifacts in form of videos and documents that are used by our partner on a regular basis. And we believe we are just getting started. E-pass system. I would like to share today one example of how great things can be achieved when Sarkar, Bazaar, and Samaj comes together to deliver value during the need of the hour. During COVID lockdown, one of the important problems to solve was how to ensure movement of essential goods and service providers during lockdown seamlessly within and across the state borders. I'm sure we all remember those days. And working in collaboration with organizations such as iSpirit, Amazon Web Services, NEGD, and Ministry of Consumer Affairs, we very quickly designed and built a highly scalable bulk e-pass system on Digit, which was rolled out in a matter of days. And this system, next slide, please. And this system was eventually used by over 8 states to register 50,000 essential service providers. And the system issued close to 1 million daily passes. This is the power of open digital platform working in collaboration with the broader ecosystem to build contextually relevant solutions in a very short period of time. The last thing I wanted to highlight today, next slide please, is as mentioned in Viraj's presentation on moving towards deepening our impact, we recently commissioned a study along with Omidia Network and Aapti Institute to explore the impact of public digital platforms and to better understand access to such platforms for the last mile users, especially the ones who are not digitally native or may have other barriers to accessing the government services digitally. Through field research conducted in multiple sites across AP, Punjab, and Tamil Nadu, researchers from Aapti set out to compare experiences of people in well-connected, well-served, high internet using areas to dark, peripheral, low internet use and often informal areas to get answers to questions like, are they able to access municipal services and through what channels do they normally do so? And the results have highlighted that citizens access service from local governments through multiple channels. They also show that there are multiple groups they still prefer to contact ULBs in person or through phone calls. The study also highlighted one very important fact about the marginalized groups, which may face additional barriers or consideration while applying for services. And finally, it also highlighted the important role played by the intermediaries, be it NGOs, local entrepreneurs, or political actors in accessing government services. This was a very quick glimpse of the impact report. I really hope everyone downloads the report and enjoy reading it the way we enjoyed making it. Next slide, Amaya. And I would finally like to end by thanking everyone who has helped us in every step of this remarkable journey. We hope to continue building out this ecosystem even more broader as we take on more challenges in the coming years. We could not have done it without you all. Thank you so much.